Hello everyone, this is Rick with Cybermedics, and we're here today to talk about the Phyn Smart Water Detection System. So let's get started. When you unbox this device, the first thing you'll want to do is put the batteries in it. And it's not exactly obvious, but you have to actually spin this little part here to get it to open, and then insert the batteries in the bottom. So that'll be the first thing you'll want to do. The second thing you'll want to do is, since you probably bought a cable to go along with it, is figure out how to plug it in. And there's little ports on the side of it, you can see, but you have to actually remove a little rubber tab, take it out in order for it to plug the cable into it. So, okay, once you've done that, you'll have to set up an account with Phyn. And so we'll get into the Phyn app here and show you how that's done. Okay, I've already set up an account with Phyn. I will get into a little bit of explanation on the account setup, only because I think you might want to know they're pretty intrusive on the information that they want to collect from you. They're going to want to collect your address, your phone number, which I can kind of understand for notifications, your email address, of course, and set up a password. But they were adamant about the address. I mean, it wasn't optional, so you had to put an address in the system to set it up. So it might just be something to be aware of when you go to set up the account. So for us today, we're going to set up this smart water sensor. And on a previous video, I had tried to set one up with the Moen flow, which didn't turn out too well. This one seems to be a lot smoother on the execution of it. So we'll go into here and just kind of follow the process along. We're going to call it test 2. And we're going to go ahead and use the defaults. It says you can get alerts for humidity. And I tell you, this Phyn seems really sophisticated in its ability to analyze data and report temperature and also humidity. So it says configure your device, telling you it's going to take 2 or 3 minutes. Now, it's saying press the button on the sensor. And that's just, let me get back over here to the sensor so I can show you that part of it. So it's just this little button on the side, not to be confused with the ports that are covered up with a little rubber tab. So anyway, we just press it once and it's blinking. So it's in its setup mode. You don't hold it, you just press it, which is a little bit different. So set this over here. Now we'll go back into the app and click on the next. All right, so it says connect to the network. So what we have to do is we have to connect to the Phyn network. There it is, Phyn water sensor. So you got to connect to that. Go back into the app. And it's pairing the device, and now you'll select your network and you'll enter your password and then click next. Okay, so strange thing there, it was saying it couldn't connect to the network, but it actually did wind up connecting to the network. It beeped. You heard a little beep on it, and the light on it turned green. So let's go in and check on the capability of the sensor. Okay, so now that it's set up, it wants to ask you some questions. So I had to close the app down to come back in to get it to initialize the device. So this is what I was talking about before, where it really wants a lot of details. Now next we'll plug in the cable and check it out with the cable alarm. So you just, like I said before, just plug it into the side of the port there. And then this whole cable is water sensing. And in one of our other videos, I mentioned that this cable is really flexible. And as you pull it tight, it actually will lay pretty flat, which is pretty important when you think about it, because if the cable doesn't lay flat, how's it going to detect the water? That was one of the problems I had with the Yolink system, is that the cable doesn't lay flat. So there we go. Now you can see it's alarming. Not very loud, so you would definitely want some external alarm device to sound in addition to this. This concludes our review of the Phyn Smart Water Sensor. If you have any questions, post them below. Consider subscribing. Rick with CyberMedics, signing out.